Hi, everyone. So today, I'm going to tell you a short story about when a close-knit JavaScript family needed a rescue from an unruly state butler. I'm Varsha, and I work for Flipkart Internet Private Limited in India. I am a huge tea addict and a shopaholic, and I love being a JavaScript developer. Before I can start telling you about this story, I would like all of you to know about the use case that we were facing while I was working for Flipkart Internet Private Limited. I was in the customer support team of Flipkart, and we had a very unique problem at hand. So Flipkart had acquired a lot of companies in the past. I don't know if you've heard of any, but then it was PhonePe, eCart, Myntra, and all. They all catered to different business sections of the e-commerce domain. So as we acquired these many companies, the job for the customer support team working for the front end, working as a front end developer in the front, in the customer support team, our job was to create a platform for all of these organizations to onboard with us. When I say platform, what I mean is that we needed to create a main application that could support for features so that when one of these sub-applications came into picture, it could provide those features to the sub-applications as well. As I said that I work for the customer support team, the features, the capabilities of the platform included the users who were our customer care agents to be able to call the customers or to be able to send an email to the customer or to be able to chat to a customer. So these are the common capabilities of a platform that I'm talking about right now. Also, each customer contact being a session. So these were the technical common functionalities that each of these sub-apps needed from the main application. When I say sub-apps, I also mean that all of these different applications had different business category to cater to. For example, Flipkart usually deals with orders, while, say, eCart deals with shipments. So there were different business groups that they were catering to. So we needed to provide a platform, but all of these sub-apps also needed to have their own individuality. They had to retain their own individuality. So these are the different sub-app layout differences that we faced. So one sub-app had a layout like this, where there were two rows, and the first row has three columns, the second row has one column, whereas sub-app two has a different kind of layout, where you have three rows, the first two rows have two columns each, while the third row has just one column. Apart from the layout differences, the visual differences, there were other functional differences as well, as I explained. So Sub-app 1 had to show order details, and it had to perform actions like sending an SMS to the customer, whereas sub-app 2 had to show shipment details, and it had to perform actions like canceling a shipment, right? So these were the functional differences that we had to think about while we were integrating all of these apps together. The major differentiator for us, the major challenge that we faced, was the non-functional difference. When we acquired these organizations, the tech teams were very different. So I belong to the tech team of Flipkart.com, while somebody else, my co-developer, my peer, belonged to a different organization. Since the tech teams were different, we were allowed to choose different tech stacks to build our own application. So we chose ReactJS, but say the other organization did not want to choose ReactJS. They just wanted to code in vanilla JavaScript, or they just wanted to use jQuery. Now, how do we create a platform that not only caters to a single tech stack application, but also caters to these various tech stacks that were coming on board with us? How do we go about state management then? How do we go about routing then? How do we even create a unified view where you know everything seems so seamless that you are using the main application features while retaining your sub-applications features? So those were the non-functional differences, and those were the basic challenges that we faced while building this application. Getting back to the topic of my talk, I'm going to tell you a short story. This is about a story of a family of two, a father React Senior and the son React Junior. They were a very happy family living in ECMA Island, and everything was fine. The father used to drop React Junior to school every day, get him back. He used to help him out with homework. So they were just happy together. But then there was war. Yeah. It's not something to laugh about. It was tragic. People died. Yeah. Anyway, so after this war, React Senior was so overwhelmed with emotions. He was so sad that he decided to adopt these two little girls from the war, the children of the war. They were so cute that he just wanted to adopt them. And one was jQuery, the other one was Vanilla. So he got them home. Now there were three kids at his place and just one adult. And you can just imagine what happened after that. So these little kids were actually no less than monsters. They were little pranksters who were going around doing all things they could do wrong. And React Senior could not do anything about it. So React Junior just lost his acid. I don't know why he needed an acid, but he could not find his acid. Vanilla stole jQuery's glasses, and she could not find her glasses. Yes, this one was really bad. One day, React Senior came down to have coffee, and he found out that somebody replaced sugar with salt. Yeah, there was one other instance where jQuery peed all around the house, because it's jQuery. So what I'm trying to say is that this is the current problem with our large-scale applications. If I translate this story to my real-world code example, I would like to say the same thing, that we, as a platform, were like React Senior, and all these little sub-apps that were joining us were like jQuery, Vanilla, and React Junior. So we had to manage these three kids together. And as you could see in the story as well, that everything was a mess. So it was same for us. Everything was a mess. State management for us between three or four apps was a mess, because you could not one part of the state cannot be shared by the another organization. That's kind of breach of business ethics. So we could not do that. And we had to figure out a way where state management was easy and state management was so robust that everybody could share the common platform state as well have their own state. So another problem was when these apps are combining together, how do we even go about doing the routing? Or how do we even bridge these two apps together, which are so different in tech stacks? One is in React, while the other is in jQuery. So how do you create that connection? How do you even have that kind of compatibility that it looks seamless to the user? So these are the problems with the large-scale applications that we faced. Well, enter the hero of our story, the lovable butler, Redux. OK, I thought the hero deserved an applause, but it's OK. So React Senior was very sad that he could not manage his three kids. And he was very sad about it, and he thought what to do, like hire an external help. And same was our condition when we were thinking about these three or four apps clubbing together into one. What should we do about it? And yes, we figured out a way. We thought that we could hire an external help for our state management. So we just used this library called Redux. And it helps us with better state management, like the butler does for React Senior. The power of Redux comes with three things. One, that it is mostly a single store. It mostly has a single store. Two, the state in Redux is non-mutable. And three, that it works on pure functions with no side effects. I'll explain how this is powerful for us. This is something to show how Redux works. If you see, there's a view layer, and all these actions that are happening in the view are actually dispatched. When they are dispatched to the store, now imagine the store as this butler who has also hired a lot of little help for himself. So there's a cook, there's a maid, there's a laundry guy, there's a car wash guy. So this butler is giving order to these say minions that he has, and they are doing all these household chores for a React Senior. So it's the same way that it works in Redux. So this store has these little reducers, the minion reducers, which are working on their part of the state. When an action is dispatched, the reducer listens to that part of the state. If it wants to act on that part of the state, it just acts on it, and it just returns a new state right? A new state, new part of the state, whatever the change state is. That state is then again combined by the store and sent to the view. So the view gets to know, the view is updated by the new state. Right, and view can be divided into a lot of components, a lot of apps. So anybody can listen to any part of the state by just subscribing to it. The Redux store provides three main APIs. One is the dispatch API, where an action is dispatched from the view to the store. The second is the get state API. So at any given point of time, if you say get state, you get the current state of the application. And third, which is the most powerful API for us, is the subscribe API. Subscribe is basically that a component or an application just wants to subscribe to the changes that have happened in the store. It gives you a callback. And whenever there's a change, you just get to know about it. So first, I'm going to show you a very simple React app that uses Redux. This is the father, React Senior, that I'm talking about. If you see the render function, there are two buttons. One button says click to sneeze, and the other button says click to burp. So as soon as one of these buttons is clicked, there's an action that gets dispatched. It says fetch medicine, either for sneeze or for burping. And if you see this function, map state to props, this is where, and the connect. So this is given by React Redux. So this is where I was talking about the subscribe API that the store gives. It incorporates that. And whenever there's a change in the store, it just immediately reads through it and then passes it again to the component. So right now, this component is listening to the medicine, what medicine needs to be taken. And in the render function, you can see that the medicine, accordingly, the medicine is displayed on the screen. If you see the action creator here, it just passes a type of action and the problem that he has. The main thing here is the reducer function again. If you see this reducer function, it's a medicine store, which on listening to the fetch medicine decides if the person has sneezed, then he needs to take what medicine. If the person has burped, then he needs to take another medicine. So. This is pretty basic React with Redux system that I'm talking about. If you want to see the working of it, it's not a very good design, but then it solves the purpose right now. When I say this is the great roof that we all share, once I show you how sub-apps are also incorporating into these main apps, it'll be more clear and it'll be more seamless right now. But this is just the main app, the React Senior app, the basic app that I'm talking about. So if I say click to sneeze, it says I need to take sneeze all. If I say click to burp, I have a bad digestion and I need to take something else. So this is the basic React app. Now let's look at an app that is a React plus React app, React Senior and React Junior. So this is the case where our main application is in ReactJS and the sub application is also in ReactJS. So we basically npm install the sub application into the main application. If you see the sub application component, it has a render method where if you see the map state to props, actually, it is also reading the part of the state from the main application, that is medicine store, and it is also reading what medicine father took. And it has its own state called handkerchief, fetch handkerchief. So once the medicine is brought, then he says, OK, do you want to fetch handkerchief? Say yes. If he presses yes, then again, the action is dispatched, and accordingly, things take place. I would also, at this point, want to show you the code here. Yes. So this is the React app here. And so this is basically doing the same thing. It is fetching handkerchief as soon as medicine is required. What I want from my sub apps, what any main application would want from sub apps, is a config structure where it can send all these reducer functions so that my main application combines these reducer functions to create a single state tree that can then be subscribed by all the sub applications or the main application. So that is what I'm doing right now. Like all these sub applications need to send a config to me, where they are giving me their reducer functions and also their routes. So all the client routes can be different, right? The main application will have a base route, and after that, all the clients can take over their routes. So what I require from any sub-application are routes and reducers. So this is the config structure. This is the basic config structure that I would require a sub app to give me. Routes, reducers, and if it is a React app, then say true. If it is not, then false. Basically, whatever the main app is. So if the main application is in AngularJS, I would prefer having the name called is Angular app true or false. But right now, the main application is in ReactJS, so I asked him whether it is true or false. This is the config structure that he provides me. Now in my main application, I have this app where I import sub-application here, and I check this again with a proper route. So right now, it's React Junior. And on this route, if you see on this route, I had on React Junior, I was rendering this component, sub-app. So right now, I have tried not to make it look seamless, but in a real world application, it does look seamless, where you have this header, you have the main application, and you also have a child application on the side. So when the main application says click to sneeze, the child application says fetch handkerchief. When you say fetch handkerchief, it just says that it's success. So coming back to the main application, how this all works, is since I showed you the config structure that I would be requiring from my sub application, this config structure is imported here, sub app config from whatever app that I'm importing, and I create a store out of it. These reducers I pass to my main store. In the store, I'm combining these reducers together, one for the main application so that each of these sub apps can actually use them, and two for the client application. So there is a client state going on here, right? So this is how it is done. The third example that I would like to show, and that is the major example here, the name says subapp vanilla, but it's actually jQuery. If you see this application structure, it's a badly written code. You just have a document load function where you are just rendering a div, and on click of div, something happens. So what do we do in such kind of situations where the sub app is so badly written, but you still want to transfer the state? You still want to manage the state in a badly written code. And this is how you do it. So you basically ask the sub app to have two functions, a callback and an init method. Init to basically initialize the application, and callback, as I explained, there's a subscribe method that goes on with Redux. So when you subscribe and you have a callback, immediately when the state changes, that callback gets called. So I expose these two functions from my sub app, and inside my main application, now how do these two apps even combine together? How does React combine with jQuery? Of course, I need to kind of create a wrapper around this jQuery application so that it is seamless to transfer data from one application to another. And that is what I do here. So as soon as, OK, now I'll import this app and comment out that app. As soon as I import the jQuery app, it creates a store with the reducers that app had. And in the routing, what I basically ask is, if it is not a React app, then please create this bridge for me. This bridge is nothing but a wrapper around the jQuery application. Yeah, sure. Is it good? So I see that the application is not in ReactJS, so I just create a wrapper around this. It's nothing but a bridge that bridges the gap between the React and the jQuery application. If I see the bridge here, it's nothing. It has a simple render method where it is just wrapping this component around a div. And in the component did mount, the original component is nothing but the component that the jQuery app had passed me, and I just call the init method from it. With this bridge and the store. So I pass down the store to my sub application here. Once I say init, this init method gets triggered, and from the config, this is the config, this init method and the callback is there. And the store has been passed down from the main application to your sub application. So you just say store.subscribe, and whatever changes that take place in the main app, this sub app will always be notified of it because it has subscribed to the store. So this is how the whole thing works. And so this is the jQuery app fitting right into my main application of the React app. I again sneeze. And what medicine did father take? The font is too small, but it does say sneeze all. So yeah, that works. So yes, this is how we solved for our use case at Flipkart to solve for these various organizations that were getting onboarded with us, which need not want to be on the same stack as we were. So we had to solve for the use case where they could be on different tech stacks and still have a better state management possibility. Still, they could use the common functionalities that our main app was providing, as well as retain their individual features. So yeah, that's it. Thank you.